So, Sabina, I mean, you're, how old are you now?
I'm 24.
Okay, so you're 24 and you just lost your virginity.
Oh my God.
So, and I bring this up because the last time that we worked together, actually it wasn't the last time, time before that, you were telling me that you were still a virgin. And I was like, because I knew that you liked girls and like you were pretty much only into women. So I was like, okay, that makes sense. That's still like so unusual, but that makes sense. But now you have broken your covenant. So what? How'd you get on the D train?
Oh my God. So I literally, it's hilarious actually. So I literally, during this COVID, I was sitting there like, damn, like I could die. Like, you know, in the beginning stages, you're like, well, I could die. And what is one thing that I have never done? And I just wanted to make sure. And I was like, you know what? I think I'm going to finally do it. I met this person. He was great. Like, honestly, he was amazing and super sweet and super kind. And I was like, oh my God, I'm going to tell you the story. You guys are going to think this is so funny. We were hanging out for 2 weeks together, never did anything sexually. We were like great friends, everything like that. We're in his car at this time. And like, I just had this urge. I'm like, I'm going to suck his dick. This is going to be the first time I've ever sucked a dick, but I'm going to do it. Like, I'm just going to do it right now. So we were like in his car. He's on the phone with his agent. Well, his like manager or whatever, because he was a musician. And he's talking to his manager, and I just start sucking his dick, and he's looking down, he's like, and then like he, on the phone, the guy's like, yo, are you getting your dick sucked right now? I was like, and he's like, I gotta go. And literally we made love in the back of his car. It was a full moon. That was probably why I felt the urge to do it.
Wow.
But it was a full moon. And then, you know, I lost my virginity in the back of a Range Rover.
Wow. Well, I mean, at least it was comfy and spacious.
Space, yeah.
I was about to ask you like a really dumb question, like what was giving your first blowjob like? But I know you've done a lot of like dildo blowjobs.
Yeah, so, like, I just did with the dildo. Like anything you guys said looked hot. I was like, okay, let me do it. And of course, like I didn't really know how to do it perfectly. Like I know how to look good, but I don't know what feels good for him. So like good thing is like
he was
very nice. Yeah, he was like, oh yeah, do it like this. I'm like, okay, thank you. And you know, we actually have been like really close ever since. Wow. We're still really great friends. We make music together. So it was just like one of those experiences that I was like, I'm either going to do it my way or not at all.
Take charge, girl.
You know?
So how was like losing your virginity? Like, because I just remember when I lost my virginity, it was so painful. It was like a horrible experience. I also,
dick is so different.
It is. I also lost it with like a horrible guy that I'd only been dating for a little while, and he was just terrible. I just made a bad decision. So what was it like for you? Did it hurt?
It did hurt at first because I had no idea. I had to like put a lot of spit down there because I was really confused. But I was really grateful because I'm used to in the industry, you know, everyone wants me to use these huge dildos because I never do boy, girl or anything. Just an average dick is perfect for me. Dick doesn't have those fake veins like on dildos. So I appreciated
You're
that.
Like, wow, this is more comfortable.
Yeah. I was like, oh, this is now I understand why it's built for women. You know, some silicone just doesn't fit. But, you know, at the end of the day, I do prefer being with a woman, but I don't mind like the feeling of the actual dick. I was so scared for so long. I was so scared that it was going to hurt, that I was going to feel terrible afterwards, that I was going to hate it and everything. But, you know, I woke up the next morning, I felt accomplished. I was like, I did something today. I did it, guys. It only took forever, but.
I like also how it was like the threat of like imminent death. Is that what got you to like finally try some dick? You're like, I might die. I guess I'll take some dick.
I'm going to take some non-COVID dick before it's too late and there's only COVID dick left. I was like, no. But yeah, that's literally why I did it.
That's so funny. So is there boy girl in your future?
Ooh, I wouldn't mind like pegging a guy. But in the meantime, I don't see myself doing any boy girl necessarily. I might do something with like, you know, trans, anything like that. But
okay. Like work your way there.
Yeah.
Like little best of both worlds.
Yeah. Cause I still like what I like.
Yeah.
I was experimenting. But hey, maybe you guys can, you know, find a way to get me into some boy girl. It all depends on the circumstance. So get creative.
I kind of actually really love the idea of like doing a trans scene as like your transitional thing.
Yeah, right.
Because I don't think that, I don't know if anyone's ever done that.
Really?
If they've done a trans scene before doing boy girl.
Oh, that's true.
I can't think of anyone who's done that.
Ooh, I'll be the first for everything. Do my like first dance.
Who do you have anyone in mind if you were to go that route?
Well, I do have a really, really, really old friend, and she knew me since before I was doing any of this. Her name is Jenna Gargles. Mm-hmm. And she and I knew each other. We both went as Aura, like, before we got into the industry. Mm-hmm. So we were, like, the only Auras in, like, the hippie commune situation that I was in. And she actually told me when I was camming, she told me, she was like, look, I know you've never met me before, but I love your camming. And showed me, like, all the pictures of my vagina on her phone. And I was like, that's an honor. I'm so grateful for this. I was like, wow, I've got a fan already. And then she got so big in the industry now. So I think it would be kind of like a fun little together, like best friends forever kind of.
Yeah.
Kind of fun slumber party. Oh, and she's got a throbbing cock. Okay. Like,
yeah, that sounds like fun. That's I'm behind you on this one.
Yay. And then Holly Randall comes in, and then now it's the three-way, and that would be great. That would be like a dream come true.
Honestly. Or I could just shoot it.
So. Yeah. Well, darn. Okay.